So many people sell themselves short in life. In this presentation, I'll explain how to see the best in yourself and in return, create the best life for yourself, by yourself, all by changing your attitude and taking accountability. Many people get complacent in their lives. They're stuck in a 9-to-5 lifestyle and think that is all they have to offer the world. Everyone should have the tools to look themselves in the mirror and feel that they have value. You can do this by enacting positive thinking. You wouldn't let anyone else talk to you negatively or say derogative comments to you, so why let yourself? We need to put out into the world what we want to see. Think positive thoughts and you'll begin to see the positive in the world. Seeing the value in yourself and enacting positive thinking can have a positive effect on the rest of the aspects in your life. We need to learn to take things into our own hands. Don't blame others for the way that you feel. Joseph Murphy, the author of Power of Your Subconscious Mind, says, quote, "The only path by which another person can upset you is through your own thoughts," end quote. We're responsible for our actions and what we do, not anyone else. We cannot blame those around us and not take responsibility. That will not lead to happiness. Blame only exists in our mind. If we choose to give into it, we will be too busy passing out blame to actually do something positive or meaningful. By not allowing blame to affect our actions, we can put our mind and thoughts to positive work and find value in ourselves and the world around us. We need to try to find and do things that help us see value in ourselves. Reading self-help books and trying to enact all learnings into your life can be a starting point of how to start changing your life and seeing the value where you did not see it before. A great self-help book to read to enact positive change is The Richest Man in Babylon by George S. Clausen. In this book, Clausen shows how we can find the good in our lives, no matter our situation or circumstance. He says, quote, "The sun that shines today is the sun that shone when thy father was born and will be the shining sun when thy last grandchild shall pass into darkness," end quote. The world will keep moving and spinning no matter what happens or what we do. We cannot blame the sun for not shining on our bad day. We cannot blame our neighbor or our coworker or our boss for affecting how we think or feel. We can always find the sun. It has always been there and will always be there if we look for it. And sometimes we have to look for it a little bit more, but it is always shining in some day if we choose to seek it. Many of these books teach us how to be happy and have a positive attitude. You need to make the choice to have a positive attitude every day. If you choose to be happy, you'll be more likely to see the good throughout your day instead of seeing the negative. In The Richest Man in Babylon, Clausen also says, "Willpower is the unflinching purpose to carry out the task you set for yourself to fulfillment," end quote. Make the choice now to change your life and change it for the better. Choose to do everything you can in a day to do your best. Push yourself to your limits. Do not procrastinate or slack off. You'll feel better about yourself day to day, and overall, the results will be outstanding. You'll be happier, feel more confident, and see more value in yourselves and what you do. If you choose to be happy and see the good in things, then eventually you'll forget most of the bad, or it won't be as obvious to you, since you'll be focusing on the good. We need to take responsibility for our actions. We need to push ourselves to learn all that we can that will help us see value in ourselves. We need to choose to have a positive attitude every day and to seek finding the shining sun. Everyone should see value in themselves, and if you enact positive thinking, the rest of the parts of your life will see positive change as well. Thank you.